All right, guys, so I'm gonna go catch a third viewing of Black Panther, and after Black Panther, I'm going to a screening of Love, Simon, which I got invited to. It's 2 weeks and a half early, so that's pretty advanced if you ask me. So, really advanced, actually. So, yeah, I'm about to head to the theater, and I'll see you guys there.
The way she talks on the phone sometimes, I'm like, oh.
Have you ever been in love?
I think so.
These last few years, it's almost like I can feel you holding your breath.
I'm supposed to be the one that decides when and where and who knows. That's supposed to be my thing.
Disclaimer, this is about to get romantic as F.
So I went ahead and I checked out a 2 week and a half early advanced screening of the movie Love, Simon. Not originally a movie that I was even planning on going to go watch in theaters. I think I was just going to rent this movie. But overall, I just got invited to a screening 2 weeks and a half early, so I said, why not? So Love, Simon is basically a story about Simon who, he's in high school and nobody really knows he's gay, and he is having a hard time coming out to both his friends and his family. But then he starts messaging a person online who also himself is gay, and he kind of starts getting close with this person, and of course Simon is pretty desperate to find out who this person is. I thought that Love, Simon was gonna be another generic teen high school movie with, you know, bland characters. It appears Love, Simon's actually the opposite of that. Love, Simon is actually a heartwarming teen romance high school movie with characters that are really engaging and that you really care about. I thought that Nick Robinson did a really good job as Simon here, especially when it comes to his most dramatic bits of the movie. I thought he did a really good job. Also really liked Josh Duhamel, that's his last name, but he plays Simon's dad. I thought he was really funny in this movie. He was really good. And same for Jennifer Gardner, who is Simon's mom. I thought that she was also a really good and supporting character. Also, the guys who play Simon's friends here are also very good. One of them was in Spider-Man Homecoming, Brigsby Bear. I can't remember what else, but he's really good in this movie as well. And you really buy the fact that they're friends. You buy the fact that they're also in high school. And that comes to one of my favorite things about this movie. This movie really depicts on high school in the most realistic way possible. As someone who's a sophomore and has been in high school for almost three years, I will say Love, Simon actually portrays high school pretty realistic. Because a lot of movies, when you see a movie take place in high school, it's not really the same as it is in real life. Here, it really does feel like, again, they're in an actual high school setting. Like, you have those kids who are, like, assholes, and they don't know what else to do besides just kind of pick on other people. And then you got your group of friends that, you know, you kind of joke around with, you know, all that. So, I thought that this movie did a really good job in capturing what high school right now actually is. This is a very well-told story about someone struggling to come out, not only to his family, but to the public. And there are a lot of scenes in this movie where you could feel the struggles and maybe even the awkward moments that our main character is going through. The thing is, this Simon guy, he's a very well-written and a very well-developed character where you really do feel and care for him. There are a lot of scenes in this movie where they put you in his shoes and then you're just sitting there kind of thinking, what would I do during a situation like this? And again, his friends really do feel like his friends and they play a major part in this story. The writing was really good here. I thought that the writing was actually going to be somewhat generic and uninteresting, but, you know, I'm calling it as it is. The writing was really interesting here. The writers did a really good job here, and same for the humor. I thought the humor was actually hilarious. I thought that this movie was going to have some comedy that really, like, tries too hard to a point where you don't even laugh, and it's just kind of like an awkward joke. But no, that's not the case here. The humor is not forced in this movie. It's actually put in scenes where you could actually use humor. So yeah, they really did use humor very good. And same with the drama. They go pretty deep with the drama here. And same with the thematic themes that they have in the third act of this movie. And maybe even sometimes it kind of feels melodramatic, where it feels like they're overacting, but it really makes sense to have that type of drama in this movie because it's done in a perfect, subtle way. In the end, guys, Love, Simon, it's a crowd pleaser. I do think you guys are really gonna like this movie. It really has the feel of a classic John Hughes movie, and it's one of the most enjoyable teen romance movies I have seen in the longest time. I really liked Love, Simon. I thought I wasn't gonna like this movie, but yet here we are, me giving Love, Simon a really positive review. You know, you should definitely pay full price to go watch this movie, and I'm gonna give Love, Simon a B+. So yeah, guys, I highly recommend checking out Love, Simon when it comes out in theaters on March 16th. I think I'm gonna go see this movie again. I just really liked it that much. I'll probably even go as far as to seeing it over Tomb Raider, but at the same time, maybe not, because I do want to see Tomb Raider and review it for you guys. But yeah, Love, Simon. I really like this movie. I think this is the type of feel-good movie that we really need, especially in a where America's like in a very dark place right now with all the tragic events and all that happening. This is a very good, heartfelt movie to have out there. I really recommend Love, Simon. Again, I cannot recommend this movie enough. Go check it out. Anyways, if you guys did manage to see it, or if you guys already seen the movie, you know, let me know what you guys thought about it in the comment section down below. As always, thanks so much for watching. Please like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys later. Bye.